Michael recently sat down for an interview with Anthony Ambrosini, a former minor league catcher who played four seasons in the Montreal Expos system, who is the founder and owner of Custom Cleats, a company that has developed a patented process to turn any pair of sneakers into cleats. And in a few moments, we'll be speaking with Dodgers catcher Russell Martin from L.A., who is an early fan and currently wears the Custom Cleats when he plays. For Anthony, his inspiration for the idea for Custom Cleats came from both his own and his younger brother's playing experience.
How did you come up with Custom Cleats?
Well, I was a minor league baseball player, formerly at the Montreal Expos, and I also played with my younger brother, who was also a player. He had suffered a stress fracture in his foot 1 year while we were in A-ball, and you know, he would wear sneakers all the way up until game time. You know, but he would be forced to wear manufactured cleats during the game. And after the game, his foot would just be killing him. I wanted to create a shoe that would be comfortable for him even during the game with the cleats on it. And I came up with that idea eventually to have a sneaker with the traction of the cleat on it.
And where did you start the process when you first started doing it?
Well, I mean, I started the process on the balcony of an apartment that I was renting with my brother during a season in A-ball. I would hold the sneaker in between my legs while working on it and eventually refine that process into something that I have today.
Who was the first person to wear one of your custom cleats after your brother?
I got the call from Lou Cucuzza, the equipment manager for the Yankees, one day, and he said that Russell Martin would like you to make some cleats for him. And ever since then, I've been working with Russell and many other athletes.
Wow. Who are some of the, let's say, more notable athletes that, through word of mouth, have been able to help you the most?
Josh Donaldson, I've done cleats for. I've done cleats for Javi Baez. And outside of baseball, I've done golf cleats for Dwayne Wade. Golf cleats for Roger Clemens. Most recently, I did three pairs of Kobe's into football cleats for a cornerback, Kareem Jackson, of the Denver Broncos.
What about some big name guys that are either heavily involved in designing shoes or obviously have their own brands, like LeBron James and Jerry Lorenzo?
When I was making cleats for Josh Donaldson, LeBron James made a comment on social media about those specific sneakers that I've turned into cleats. He really loved the idea of Josh Donaldson wearing his sneaker on the baseball field as a cleat. And also guys like Jerry Lorenzo, most recently we converted the Fear of God shoe for Clint Frazier, and he loved the idea so much, he reached out to me and he sent me three pairs to do for his family members.
If a baseball player wanted to buy a custom cleat and have this process made, what are the different price levels?
Well, the price for a baseball standard conversion is $135. You would pick a sneaker that fits your style, your comfort, and your foot. Because I think that's the most valuable thing of what I'm doing, is because it's so personalized to you, you would pick out that shoe that you want me to convert into a cleat.
How many pairs of cleats did you make in 2018?
I mean, broadly, I would say thousands.
Thousands?
Thousands.
How many people do you have working for you now?
You know, there's a handful, but to be honest with you, I like to keep that that workspace smaller because it's very important to me to have a quality product that's put out, and to be able to put my hand on every single conversion, I think, is important.
The sneaker is becoming something that, from Custom Cleats, like, the athlete is known for.
Yeah, I really think it's taking a life of its own. And that's the great thing about what I believe Major League Baseball is moving towards, allowing the players to individualize themselves, where they're expressing their own style. And I really believe shoes in general is a way to do that.
There'll be more room for you to improvise and collaborate with the athletes.
We did a cleat for Adam Jones. He had it custom painted, and all the emojis he had painted on the shoe were all of fast food. I would say that would be the extreme version of expressing themselves, but I think it's great.
Do any athletes have multiple types of cleat bottoms? You know, I'm just thinking, you know, fields are all different, right?
Sure.
There's artificial turf, natural grass, and then even within those, there are different types of fields where they wear different shoes.
Sure. A guy like Russell Martin, he obviously wears a metal pair of metal cleats on the field, but usually guys wear a turf shoe for batting practice or pregame stuff. and we offer a turf bottom for conversion for turf fields or pregame work, you know. So, and obviously on the golf course, we offer a different kind of cleat bottom, which would be a golf cleat, and it reacts just like a regular golf cleat that you've bought. Where the cleat bottoms wear down, you can unscrew them, put new set in, and you're off and going.
Is there any pushback? I mean, I'm thinking of the big branded sneaker companies, because I would think they love to see their cleats on their shoe for a particular sport, as opposed to a custom cleat.
Right. I would say that there's a little pushback. You know, of course, the companies that create cleats, existing cleats, you know, they want their players to wear the manufactured cleats. But I do feel there is a space where we can both exist. I feel like if we can collaborate and have an offering to all customers to say, well, this sneaker, we can give you an added option for it. So it can be an added use. I don't feel like I'm taking anything away from any brands. I think I'm adding to it.
The conversion process, is it something that's trademarked or patented?
I do. I have the patent on the process of turning a sneaker into a cleat, and I think that's very important to own that idea, and create it as my own.
Do you ever get a sense that some of the big branded sneaker companies are maybe trying to, well, let's not use the word steal, but get a peek at your technology somehow, maybe like by ordering some of your cleats and then taking it apart and reverse engineering?
I would say I know they're interested.
Maybe at some point they're going to either have to partner with you or buy you.
I would be welcome.